The state television company Western Armenia represents the most important events of these days. Today's broadcast. Spring has come earlier in Halfeti, Western Armenia. Artsakh resumes searching for missing servicemen and casualties of war. The Foreign Minister of Armenia, Aray Vazian, to pay a visit to United Arab Emirates. The President of Russia and Turkey launched a discussion via video conference. The school building in the Aravno village, Kashatak, is being restored. Maten Adaryan to organize miniature painting courses. The book Architect of Genocide about Talat Pasha has been translated into Turkish. Interview with Mari Barsaryan Khanjian. Some trees have already bloomed as a result of warm spring in historic Halfeti province, Urfa, Western Armenia. Halfeti was included in the Quiet City Network in 2013. The province is known as a hidden paradise of the region with its historic stone houses and natural beauty. The city has got an image of a coastal city thanks to Lake Birecik Dam, although it is located in the middle of southeastern valley. Trees will soon bear fruit in case the weather stays above normal. After a two-day weather-related stop, the Artsakh authorities relaunched search operations for missing servicemen and casualties of war, the Interior Ministry said. So far, Artsakh rescuers retrieved the remains of 1,490 casualties since the ceasefire was declared. On March 10, the search and rescue mission will continue in Martuni and Varanda. The Foreign Minister of Armenia will pay a visit to the United Arab Emirates. As the Foreign Ministry of the Republic of Armenia reports, discussions between the Foreign Minister of the United Arab Emirates, Abdallah bin Zayed Al Nahyan, and the Foreign Minister of the Republic of Armenia, Ara Ayvazian, will take place on March 11. On March 10, President of Russia Vladimir Putin and President of Turkey Recep Tayyip Erdogan attended, via video conference, a ceremony to launch the construction of the third power unit of the Akuyu nuclear power plant. Akuyu is a nuclear power plant that Rosatom is building in the province of Mersin, Cilicia, on the shores of the Mediterranean Sea. The plant is to have four power units. It is to be the first nuclear power plant in Turkey. This is almost entirely a Russian project. Last night, Moscow officially announced that it was satisfied with the verdict in the murder case of Russian ambassador to Turkey, Andrei Karlov. Ankara's highest criminal court has sentenced five people to life imprisonment for the murder case of Karlov. We would also like to add that the foreign ministers of Russia and Turkey will meet today in Doha. Details of the agenda of the meeting are not yet available. However, we can expect for the sides to address the Karabakh issue, specifically the trilateral agreement signed on the night of November 10. Restoring the school building named after Garagin Nazdey in Aravno village Kashatak has resumed. Work in the garden is also under construction. The headmaster of the school, Boris Agabegyan, told in a conversation with Armen Press. Repairing of unfinished school building in Aravno remained unfinished as a result of the war. It has been about a week since the repair works were resumed with the support of Armenian benefactors. A kindergarten for 30 children will also be built in the school building besides the bathrooms and other classrooms. The population is still coming back. We now have 17 preschoolers in the village and 34 students in the school. The mayor of the village, Andranik Chavushyan, personally brings 11 students from Berdzor to our school every day. 90% of our teachers have also returned, Bogosyan said. Touching upon the security issue, the headmaster of Aravno first of all mentioned that the village will remain Armenian only by being improved. They continue to solve the security problem with the help of self-organization. The Majdoz Foundation for the Preservation and Development of Armenian Culture in Maten Adaryan organizes miniature painting courses for adults who like painting and are interested in Armenian miniature painting. The course will include 6 lessons per month, a theoretical lesson, and a tour in Maten Adaryan, during which participants will have the opportunity to learn the basics of miniature painting. Miniature painter Lilith Vardumyan will lead the course. In order to learn more, call +374 10 513049 or send request to mashdotsfoundation@gmail.com. The book Talat Pasha, Father of Modern Turkey, Architect of Genocide by an expert on the final period of Ottoman and Turkish history at the University of Zurich, Professor Hans Lucas Kaiser, has been translated into Turkish. Ermeni Haber reports. Two circumstances about the translation raised angerness in the Turkish media. The first was the Architect of Genocide phrase in the title of the book. The second was the fact that İletim Yayılanlar, Turkish independent publishing house, replaced the Father of Modern Turkey with the Brain of Itihad, while translating it from English to Turkish. A version of the book, titled Talat Pasha, The Brain of Itihad, Architect of Genocide, has been described by Turks as propaganda of accusations of so-called genocide. On Western Armenia TV, Mari Barseghyan Khanjian presented the role and importance of the state in the nation's life, giving details about important episodes of history which had a huge role in the process of forming a pro-state mentality. Intellectuals, politicians and statesmen forming the core of the state had to implement the sense of importance of the state into the nation, which unfortunately did not happen. In order to create a pro-state nation, we should start loving our motherland, and each person should start from their home and family. There is an indivisible formula. Every man strengthens his home, and every nation must strengthen its country. No one will do it for us, the publicist concluded. Now we present you Hamshani Mani by Sasun Ensemble.
Gantheşere, acaba boynuma baktınil, şapa turvanı kişere. Acaba boynuma baktınil, şapa turvanı kişere.
The full version is available on the official website of Western Armenia TV. This was all for today. Goodbye.